grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
Our grace, your eminence, right reverend of very reverend Monsignor, very reverend our reverend fathers, reverend sisters, reverend brothers, beloved people of God, I invite you to kindly sit. Stop Elias. This foundation is historic with 12 buildings, the highest number in the archdiocese of Lagos to be completed in recent times.
His Grace, Most Reverend Alfred Adewale Martins, the Archbishop of the Metropolitan See of Lagos, His Eminence Anthony Cardinal Okoje, Archbishop Emeritus of Lagos, Right Reverend Boxer, Major Seminarians, Reverend Sisters, Paper Knights and Medalists, His Royal Majesty the Oba of Ibadan and His Entourage, distinguished guests here present, parents and family members of the Ordinance, members of the Archdiocesan Ordination Committee, as well as the Local Organizing Committee of St. Ferdinand, gentlemen and ladies of the press, dear brothers and sisters in Christ. On behalf of the pastoral team and the good people of St. Ferdinand Catholic Church in Ibadan, London, it is my pleasure to welcome you all to this memorable and historic occasion of the priestly ordination of our 12 deacons, whom I call the 12 apostles. We are indeed very grateful for being found worthy to be the host of this ordination ceremony, an occasion that is memorable and historical in the Archdiocese, as this is the first time 12 deacons will be ordained priests in a single ceremony in the Archdiocese of Lagos. We feel highly privileged to be a part of this pleasant history, and to your grace we say thank you very much for this great honor. It is providential that in May this year, St. Ferdinand in Ibadan, London, celebrated 30 years of our existence as a parish. And how blessed we are that in this same year, we are hosting the Archdiocesan Priestly Ordinations. To God be the glory. We therefore His Eminence, all priests, and all of you here present this morning to relax, feel at home, and savor the beautiful atmosphere, the refreshing environment. well as the warm hospitality of St. Ferdinand in Bata, London. Thank you and God.
We shall now rise as the Mass continues in meditation.
Dear sisters in the Lord, rejoice in the love of the Lord, which has given us the opportunity of coming together in worship today. We pray that our act of worship will be acceptable in the sight of the Lord. We pray that all the songs and all the prayers and all other activities of worship will not be in vain. Let us pray particularly in thanksgiving to God for the gift of the priesthood and for giving that gift to these men to be ordained today. We pray that the ordination will bring joy, will bring growth, and will bring all the graces necessary for the establishment and expansion of the kingdom of God in our archdiocese. We prepare ourselves to celebrate this Mass of ordination. Let us call to mind our sins. Let us be sorry for them all and ask the Lord for pardon.
for service. He can deal gently with the ignorant and wayward, since he himself is visited with weakness. Because of this, he is bound to offer sacrifice for his own sins, as well as for those of the people. Anyone does not take the honor upon himself, but he is called by God, just as Aaron was. So also, Christ did not exalt himself to be made a high priest, but was appointed by him who said to him, "You are my son. Today I have begotten you." As he says also in another place, "You are a priest forever, according to the order of Melchizedek." In the days of the flesh, Jesus offered up prayers and supplications with loud cries and tears to him who was able to save him from death, and he was held for his godly fear. Although he was a son, he learned obedience through what he suffered. And being made perfect, he became the source of eternal salvation to all who obey him. By God, a high priest according to the order of Melchizedek. The word of the Lord.
Because they are not of the world, even
because I am not of the world. I do not pray that you should take them out of the world, but that you should keep them from the evil one. They are not of the world, even as I am not of the world. Sanctify them in the truth. Your word is truth. As you did send me into the world, so I have sent them into the world. And for their sake, I consecrate myself, that they also may be consecrated in truth.
Present.
Reverend Gabriel Goje.
Present.